to watch, like the lead up to some of these key decisions. The phases we talked about it all the time also were highlighted on the analyst desk because they were correctly identified as the three major moments and turning points in the game. We need to see if Fnatic solve some of their issues with more crowd control and maybe more forward gameplay, potentially either banning the Jhin or picking it up in first rotation themselves.
Well, we've got a few more bans to go and see if that's the case. The Azir is banned by G2 once again. They ban Olaf themselves this time, and Fnatic on red side with the Vladimir expected thus far.
Yeah, Fnatic, stuck on red side, you have some mandatory bans like Vladimir and potentially Nidalee that you have to do. That's where you have to start dropping some of these kind of flavor bans like the Bard potentially, or maybe even like comfort picks from last game. You know, in the best of series, you always want to hit on some champs that performed very well in the previous game and at least force the enemy team to go out of their comfort zone.
Yeah, well, if there's anybody that's, any team rather, that knows about adapting and playing best of series, it has got to be Fnatic. So much history there, so many games that they've got under their belt just across all the competition. And they co-insay it themselves all the time. You watch Life of Legends, they say things like, you can't come into best of two without more than one strategy. You can't let yourself get down from a loss. Yes, be mad, but go ahead and get even the next time around. Yep. Karma is the last ban for G2 right now.
And if you're reckless, you can't come into any champs like without Suave hair. Always,
that's very true as well.
Has that hair game on point as we wait for the last ban. I just want to see what
I mean,
the are.
It's a very valid thing, Prepa. It's great color casting. Great
color casting there, yeah. The hairdo.
All right, so they leave the Nidalee open here. They're banning out Sivir. This should be a no-brainer pickup, and it is.
Interesting. Maybe, do they think Sivir lanes well into Jhin because you can always kind of counteract one of the ultimate shots or one of the Ws, and are they going to pick up the Jhin early?
I think that might be the case. You know, Reckless was one of the first early evangelists of Jhin.
Also, Zen plays a mean Sivir pick just in general. He turns the tides in a lot of late game teamfights, and he adds mobility to this already kind of all over the place G2 roster. She's also really good as a kind of cornerstone in the 1-3-1 in the mid lane holding. So I think that ban kind of sticks, and now when you see where Zen goes, if he goes for a slower Caitlyn, she doesn't fit in 1-3-1 style. I mean, actually, I like her in 1-3-1s, but she has less wave clear. But she's more on the back foot because Caitlyn generally defends with her traps, as opposed to playing aggressively and looking for picks.
All right, well, with more of the junglers freed up right now, Spirit can go ahead and get his hands on an early game pressure as well in the form of the Elise. Timer ticks down, and I think you might be right here.
Yeah.
To win, that's what Fnatic are thinking this game.
Yeah, Jhin lock-in plus Elise, really potent combination here, but that's what we talked about. Flavor bans like this Bard are suddenly falling out, and now Mythi can answer. And into low mobility AD carries in standard lanes, Bard can counteract a lot of the poke from Jhin, and if you hit level 6, he's such an easy target to get Tempered Fate on, and you can then just combo him down, maybe even connect the spear here. So already a much more exciting early game coming on here, hoping for standard lanes, really, really hoping for standard lanes, because then some of these picks can really shine.
For G2 still contemplating what their next couple of picks are going to be. Obviously, we can expect those mid lanes to not be revealed until the very last minute, which means we might start looking at the top and the AD carry, but maybe I'm wrong, and maybe they do lock in the Ryze. I doubt it, though.
I think they will. I mean, if he hovers it for this long, who knows? Because he's off the Zillion right now. Azir's out of the equation. And Victor doesn't seem to suit
Well,
that
you're right.
Yeah, so I think he prefers going blind Ryze. Because, again, G2 love playing 1-3-1. Like, it's their preferential style. And Victor, you can't play 1-3-1. Now, Fnatic know that what they're up against. They're probably going to leave top lane as their last counter pick and just lock something in mid here.
No reason not to for the time being, so you can get an advantageous matchup in just about every one of those. For Febiven, he, of course, sharing a lot of that champion pool. But, you know, a lot of it taken away. Azir, Vladimir, pretty much must-bans against these two. Vladimir in general.
It's not dead. It's between Victor and Swain. I honestly like to see a Swain. I think he could do decently well here. So much raw crowd control effects.
Oh, no.
Okay.
Don't go for the cow. Don't do it.
He's asking.
No.
Can I play it?
No. Don't like Alistar here, but I think Yellowstar is kind of out of options.
Yeah, definitely having him whittled away as the timer ticks down. They will in the last couple of seconds. Ooh, okay, just toying with us for a second. And he locks in the Victor.
Yeah, so you can definitely see what his thought process is once he cycles through these picks. He wants something, you know, that packs a punch, that can maybe get some kill pressure on his Ryze, but he's like, nah, not sure. Victor, really good late game insurance in terms of team fights, has a okay lane into Ryze, both actually just farm. Especially Cleanse Victor can get out of the snare then. I don't like Alistar, and I need to see how well Yellowstar performs in this Alistar. If he gets stuck in a standard lane, I fear they will just get out laned 2v2.
Yeah, we haven't really seen a whole lot of Alistar as of late here in Europe, and Yellowstar pulling it out. I'm curious to see what plan they have in mind. Maybe they opt for the lane swap instead.
They almost must. We'll get more information once we see these top lane picks come out. Let's see what Sven opts in here for. It's either going to be Ashe or Caitlyn. The Killista, however, is a bit of a troll. Likely to be going to be Ashe since it's preferred over Caitlyn, I feel, for a player like Sven.
And the last couple of seconds tick down. They do, in fact, lock in the Gnar for Expect. That's a mean bit of damage on that team right now. Good mix of it, too.
And that means Febben has to switch to Cleanse now. If he goes just Exhaust Victor, he's going to be a sitting duck for all these ultimates coming at him. Look at the big potential on this Victor here. Bard, Ashe, any members of G2 disappear into Fog of War, and Febben suddenly has to play in the back foot in the mid lane.
Well, he's definitely been on the up and up this split so far, but he's got himself a pretty big challenge trying to bring his team back to 1-1 on this series and keep themselves in the dominating first place position. But it's only one point that separates these two teams, and it's about to change if they can't get themselves a victory here. What is that last lock, and what do they put Gamsu on right now?
I mean, at this point, you can't lock any melee matchups that get outlaned by Gnar. It's like Trundle kind of gets beaten. It will be maybe a Shen.
Okay, we've seen this once before.
It's like that. This is a counter pick, so. But you need to keep connecting your Qs. Went all the while to play it against Cavoshard, and maybe Cavoshard can shed some more light on it later on the desk. Cavoshard kind of didn't carry on this matchup because he kept missing his Qs in lane and didn't go for the EQ combo. This matchup is all about landing EQ combo aggressively as Jarvan, but then you need to know where the enemy jungler is. Spirit has really good innate synergy with both bot lane and top lane too. Gank potential is incredibly high. He will get outfarmed by Nidalee if he doesn't stick any of these ganks though. So really interesting dynamics that we have going into these games. But super passive bot lane on the same side too. I still think this worries me because now Fnatic tells us with this draft, hey, I want to lane top 1v1. But their bot lane tells us that they want a lane swap because Jhin and Alistar should get absolutely murdered in the 2v2.
Well, either way, they make not the most optimal decision in that case, but we'll have to see if this Jarvan pick can definitely help save them out a little bit more. As the coaches shake hands for the final time today, will Fnatic prevail? Will they get themselves another win or one win to even up this series? Or is G2 going to take that very, very dominating 2-0?
Yeah, I'm having issues adding it all up here.
The math is hard on broadcast. I know about that,
Greppo. It's just about all these matchups and how they interact. And I wonder where Spirit is going to spend his time. He's going to look to equalize the bot lane. Am I overrating Ashe Bard into Jhin Alistar? Is the camp from Spirit and Gamster enough to put Expect in a dumpster and then have Fnatic play passive on the bot lane, something they've done in the past? There's so many questions here that we need answering on.
All these questions and more, they're about to be answered as we load up onto the Rift. It's game two, it's G2, it's Fnatic, the two best teams in Europe. Let's hear it one more time. Who's gonna take this victory? Big welcome to Summoner's Rift. The crowd beats out a nice rhythm there. Mm-hmm. Reckless and Sven will find each other.
All right, we can get into what these comps need to do in the mid-game later on. Let's just focus on some of the particular matchups here. Keep track. Really good deep ward here by Mithy because he saw the poke come out on Reckless. So now they have information on Gromp, which is always key in some of these melee support matchups. You'll want to accelerate any champion to level 2.
At least Gamsu's got the right skin.
Sven is on a ward, so now Fnatic have info. More info than, honestly, G2 have right now. And it does look like lane swap. Yep.
Give themselves a little bit of breathing space here. So, Gamsu, obviously he won't be taking the 1v1 for a while, but when you get those long lanes, I guess it still functions that way. So, you know, we could start to see this game start to turn in that favor, but it's all the gamble.
It's a good
pull off.
It's good ward here. Look at the bottom of your screen. It's about to fade the ward that Sven is on right now. Honestly, it gave Fnatic all the information for the lane swap. I don't think G2 was aware of that ward being placed. And they aggressively move in here into the enemy jungle as a four-man squad too. So look at where Spirit's starting deep into the enemy jungle here. So this is honestly the perfect lane swap start here for Fnatic. So they take a really good opening here.
Spirit Gamsu get the double jungle on. They'll clear away the blue. And The jungle, the map itself, it gets divided down that mid lane right now.
And that's the risk of going for that delayed invade on Gromp in this matchup here. Now, Mythy is looking to mimic something a lot of Karma players do. Bard is also fantastic as a champion to come up behind it, because Fevin needs to path into the left side of the lane. This is the right escape path. If you go down, you will have to use your flash.
Yeah. Speaking of Fevin too, he didn't end up swapping on his summoner. He's still rocking the exhaust right now. He might be a very juicy target come those skirmishes, come those fights. For both these teams, the Perks is taking a little bit of damage, poke in the mid lane. It's obviously just a few love taps, and we get ourselves into the fast push.
Better champions still on the side of G2, although it's very minor. Honestly, I guess Gamsu can give everybody attack speed with his flag, starting the correct spell for lane swap. It's these little things, but might as well analyze them because nothing else is going on.
Well, it's just, it's... These are two teams that play at such a high level. The little mistakes, the little differences, that's what makes the difference.
Yep.
It's what you were talking about with the lane swap oopsie that happened last game from Gamsu.
Yeah, that was a major mistake. So you either analyze how the speed is influenced by some of the key champion choices, or you talk about Game of Thrones and Star Wars. That's all you can do as a color caster in a lane swap.
I mean, you've got two functions.
Two functions, yeah. We got a binary tree here.
All right, well, the decision is telling me right now that the towers are going to get traded. That's my color casting.
Fantastic.
I know. Well,
and who got the gold, Pyra?
Ah, I think the top laner.
Top laner.
Hell.
All the gold, both of these.
Excellent.
This time, slightly quicker on the draw on the side of G2, as we expected, given their champion choices.
All right, so we'll get into those long lanes, and we'll see if Gamsu recovers from that mistake he made last game around. This time, Drake is way less of an early liability because you've got the Cloud coming up first.
So this is the difference here. Gamsu is slow right now. In last game, Gamsu was pushing right now, just to indicate to people, viewers were asking me what went wrong. Now Mythy passes on the ward. Now Gamsu has the, honestly, permission to push, but they're going for the, honestly, a reverse cheese here. Support wants to zone off the enemy top laner here, but look at where jungler is. It almost worked. Spirit almost managed to get in time into that rush, because every time a support wants to zone off the enemy top laner, he will go hyper aggressive. And this looks a little dumb here from Fnatic now, but this was almost a beautiful cheese. And Mythy could have straight up died there if Spirit was just 2 seconds quicker. Now Yellow starts coming around, and this is an aggressive punish and adaptation. With no Bard Q available here, did Mythy skill Portal level 2?
Oh,
yes, he did!
We flashed it! There's the magical journey. Yellowstar follows through. That's a long one, and in comes Spirit, but they turn their attention to Sven, and he's desperately trying to outtrade and flash into that portal. He gets knocked up, but in comes Expect. Summoner heal, and that's First Blood over to Expect.
Oh, we have to talk about all this again. Let's see how it plays out. Spirit.
That's going to be a 2-for-1.
Kill, but Expect comes in here with another really good reactionary teleport.
And a flash! Oh!
He's dead!
Oh no! Spirit!
3-for-1 G2 Esports! And this play gets turned upside down here. I love the initiative from Fnatic, but it was too disjointed. They need to strike immediately. They need the element of surprise. So Spirit should have been in that brush. Cocoon Mythy, and suddenly he's like, oh my god, why is the jungler here? But G2 had too much time playing that out, and the beautiful flash from Mythy. Also, he skilled Portal level 2 in the lane swap. Most bars in lane skill health pack level 2. That's again a minor adaptation that you never see punished, but here it is. Yeah, Yellowstar. You can't go for the combo. You just have to play zone control. You need to wait until maybe Mythy walks up to a wall, and then you need to Q flash. If you W, it's too telegraphed. Any good player can actually flash a W traveling on land. And I mean, you have to call it out. If you go at Mythy, I don't think you can open with W. You always have to Q flash and pray that you're quicker and that you don't get red. And then Trick comes in here. Teleport from Expect was on point. And suddenly this play from Fnatic, they committed to it. It failed in the setup where Spirit was revealed, but they kept committed to it afterwards. And G2 beautifully turned it around. Also, the presence of mind for Sven, not even flash. He was just winning. He knew Expect was coming, used the heal, and suddenly Fnatic find themselves 1.5k gold. And now a tower behind.
And a lot of that gold sitting in the pocket of Expect as well. You know, keep hitting that theme of starved top laners. Well, it's definitely not been the case for G2.
600 gold ahead right now, Pyro. This is massive. This is almost a game over. Fnatic really need to look for an aggressive pick.
Well, Fnatic on the back foot yet again this time. G2 really showing up and showing that they can predict, they can adapt. Before Fnatic even makes some of these moves, it's been troubling for them to deal with the raw power and the quick decision-making that G2 have. Well, let's take a look at this one again. What happened in the mid lane? Fabivin, well, he kind of got jumped on. This wasn't quite enough damage right in the beginning, but they did manage to polish him off, by the way. So even more gold on the side of G2.
Yeah.
Mark's grabbing it.
Even more gold here. Feverman dropping two. So just getting worse here. And now Trick is firing ahead too. Keep track of the levels here, because we only watch gold, but Trick 6 to Spirits 5. Expect 4, but with a massive gold advantage. To Gamsu's 4, relatively even in experience. Perks is in the game too. And Sven and Mithy, yeah, doing well for themselves as well. Remember, they only get online on level 6. Ash Arrow and Tempered Fate, really good at catching out any of these Jhin and Victor picks.
It's a dangerous game Fnatic are playing right now. Trying to keep the waves at bay here. Sven and Mithy pushing it in with impunity. They know that Fnatic can't bring up anything around the rear. The vision game fairly strong for them right now.
And Alistar from behind is almost impossible to play. I mean, look at Yelta. Level 3 Mobi Boots. That's all he has. And if he goes for a combo, his flash isn't cooldown right now. It'll be super telegraphed. You can always portal out and people can just flash it. And that's the problem with Alistar, with the cooldown reduction boots. I mean, the summoner cooldown being removed, the distortion enchant. Alistar actually went down a lot in value because he needed that flash every 3 minutes. Every 5 minutes, it's just simply not enough.
Yeah, this is why we're not seeing very much of it, but Yellowstar, he took the gamble. It's not paid off for him, and they find themselves down. 2,000 gold difference is huge, and G2, look at this. They're not even...
Yeah,
push nobody bot. Pushing on the mid.
Yeah, it's push bot collapse mid because they sent Victor to base here, and they're losing that window. Fnatic's looking for a desperate collapse here. Yellowstar almost has flash, so Fnatic right now, they want to go for flash combo into flash flag and drag. Because Gamsu pushing top and he can't really hold there against Expect.
Oh boy, it's not good when you're already trying to make desperate plays at 8.5 minutes. Perks having absolutely no trouble now, getting a lot more farm up on Febivin as things are rolling on forward. Trick doing the same to Spirit in this jungle, and you know, they're starting to control the map, control the pace of the game yet again.
And this matchup is so crucial and it relies on Gamsu being able to use his kit to get ahead of the Gnar. Now that Expect has a gold lead, he can really counteract a lot of this all-in potential, this poke potential with Gamsu. Gamsu will get out-traded. Gnar went through the roughest part of the matchup too, which is 1-5. Level 7 plus Gnar can beat most melee matchups, and now also he will just have the confidence. Expect is definitely being catered towards more in this series. One time by choice, and this time by a really good communicated TP.
Fnatic grouping here on this top side. They're looking to try and collapse on Expect.
Yeah, look, they're looking for double flash here.
Dive.
But look at how desperate this move is, you know? When support is at enemy tier 2 looking for a flash dive, Reckless pathing over.
Oh, they know.
They saw him. Like, it's so telegraphed, so obvious. Hopefully, G2 learns, communicates, and Expect plays back.
Communication definitely not an issue on G2's side right now. Fnatic are going to go ahead and four-man push this bottom side.
Good move, good move. Just keep trading. If you're behind, you want to keep trading evenly to make that gold advantage relatively less impactful, you know? If it stays at 2k gold for the rest of the game, great. By 30k gold each, it's slightly irrelevant. The problem is G2 is picking away both mid lane and bot lane at the same time.
Yeah, right now they're going to lose this outer here. If G2 can grab another tower in the bottom, that can give them an even more valuable trade. But for the time being, it's just going to be that mid. It's actually a long time for Fnatic to really take this back, and that's free damage that Sven's getting. Yeah, really doubling up in value here.
Yep.
That's going to be enough for the tower.
Focus fire on that tower. They did a good job bouncing the wave on the bottom lane, but Expect's already there catching it. Yeah, a 1-for-2 tower trade here, plus the map, plus the vision in between. Exit stage left in the portal, if needed. Satisfying sound effect.
I can imagine for you especially. It's 10 minutes. This is a huge lead already for G2. No one needs to really bother about the Cloud Drake, but G2 can take whatever they want at their leisure. They may have lost an inner tower on the top side, but they're not too concerned about it. Expect is more than capable of holding it. The Black Cleaver build is time coming in for him. Yeah, it's...
Imagine if you're Jarvan.
It's 11.
Like, guys, give it to me. I got the secret weapon. Jarvan counterpick. And then you look at 11 minutes. Ah, damn, an enemy has Black Cleaver. Can we open?
All right,
Let's
here you come. They're going to try to collapse. He's bringing some friends. He's bringing Spirit at least. But that's a pretty big minion wave as well, and Expect's got a pretty heavy Gnar bar.
Yeah, Expect doesn't care. He sees Yellowstar in the bottom lane, which means he's safe, because he can almost 1v2. And Mithy's shadowing. Look, Mithy knows that the only gank that's going to come is top lane, because nobody's going to gank mid lane. Nobody's going to gank this Ryze, who's lonesome, fully covered in wards in the bot lane. So by process of elimination, Mithy's only job is to keep his top laner safe.
All right, well, I see you've done your homework. Now, you got any more of those Game of Thrones references?
It doesn't work if you're obvious about them, Pyra.
Hey, man, you brought it up earlier. All right. Yeah, this is just textbook, though. G2, I mean, they ran a clinic last game in 40 minutes on Fnatic, and they're doing it again. Yellowstar desperately trying to head down. it's just, it's so crazy to see them do this to a team that A is currently sitting in first place.
Fnatic dug themselves their own hole, you know? They went for a really nice play. I like it. It's cheeky. If Spirit's in the brush, it works. If he's not in the brush, sometimes you gotta be ready to abort mission.
Yeah, but this is the power of G2 to force decisions that aren't very optimal, or at least to force you into a bad decision tree.
You once your good decision turns bad. Like any good decision can turn bad if you wait long enough. There's like Gap is staying here, could turn bad, but he makes the quick decision.
Yeah. Well, it's all about using the EQ combo.
Look at him. Presses E, presses Q, flags and drags.
And it's going to be another tower, though, for G2. I mean, they're losing ground rapidly on the side of Fnatic here. The gold just keeps on flowing. And G2 Esports, again, they do not have to fight. They do not have to engage at all. They can just keep the pressure coming. And Fnatic, they just don't react in time. There's nothing they can really do here to get back into this game, barring forcing a big fight, a big catch. They don't seem to have the tools to do it either. Well, it's just not happening right now for Fnatic. And you know, time seems to be running out for the team. They'll definitely have to take a good hard look at this series, no matter how it shakes out.
Yeah, it's gonna be, it's looking like a three-pointer here. And I like the progression from G2. I mean, coming into the series, one of their issues was Expect not being, like, communicating with the team in crucial mid-game decisions. We've had accelerated mid-games where G2 was playing from ahead, so we can't really be conclusive about them having solved that issue, but there's groundwork being done.
Well, you know, we've heard a little bit from some of the G2 players about the work they're doing on that. A couple weeks ago, Sven, you know, he had an interview, said, hey, you know, look, Expect may not speak that much, but he's talking, or rather, he's understanding just about everything, and he's working on all these words that he's not quite confident in.
Just like
sitting
me.
With him every night. Yeah, there you go. It's a common thing here, if you're not a native English speaker, I suppose.
We have vocal coaching.
We do.
Apparently, I mispronounce a lot of words.
That's okay. It's what makes you unique, Crepo?
It's a TH sound. So if I start talking about dough instead of dough, that's when I'm not a rapper, you know?
I will keep that in
mind. Not talking about the mad dough. I'm also not a baker.
You're killing me. but yeah, G2, I mean, you can see the work that they're putting in paying off in this week right now. They've clearly brought their A game.
I mean, we have nothing left to talk about, Pyro. This is where we fill and hope that everybody is entertained during the cast, because G2, they take one big chunk out of Fnatic. They punish one play, and then they play the map, and that is top tier League of Legends, because teams have gotten so good at knowing how to close out games, and Fnatic, from behind, with this draft again, things like Alistar from behind just simply don't work, because it's a shotgun approach, and it's too obvious to dodge for G2. Like, you need multiple champions. If you have, like, a Bard or, yeah, maybe a CDR boot special, it would still exist, you know, to kind of find some opening and hooks here. But G2 can always react here. They're too far ahead, and they're so good at playing the league, too.
So good at playing when ahead, and they just put themselves into this situation constantly. Next trick's going to be Infernal as well. Obviously, the Dragons haven't played out as a very important role, with the Cloud being the first one that's hit the Rift. But it's just now with this Infernal that'll eventually come up, it's even more for G2 to just easily take away. There's no in for Fnatic. They just can't find any way to get a pickoff. I mean, Spirit didn't have the impact he needed early on. There's the Jhin ulti. Reckless is going to try to get a zone away, but
still have Arrow, still have all the flashes.
You've got everything.
They still have a magical journey.
Several, in fact. Oh, there's the Tempered Fate. It's going to land onto Spirit. And in comes the Arrow. It's going to hit him right in the back after the Nidalee Spear. And Fnatic are running scared. Meanwhile, Perks
sold gas to the top lane. I didn't even know what that counter engage was from G2. Honestly, it wasn't the best. It worked somewhat, but none of their teleporters was actually in a position to teleport in. So that's a mistake. We can fault them for that.
There you go.
They could have killed more people.
It's a mistake. The team that is currently sitting 5,000 gold in the lead, 5-1. All right. Let's take a look at what happened.
So
here
I asked for this replay again.
Earlier.
Usually we don't go back this far in time. The point where it fails is obviously here. Beautiful flash from Mithy. Replay should have actually started much sooner. This is the follow-up of the play that failed. Mithy baits two people into Portal 2 and everybody ignores Sven. The presence of mind for him to just keep whittling down Gamsu here. He doesn't even have to flash the EQ combo because he knows Expect is coming in. And everybody took the magical journey trying to focus on Mithy. But the start of this play was this brush on the top of your screen here. The first top lane burst. That's what Spirit was trying to enter to then kill Mithy, who was going to zone off Gamsu from the wave. The second he was spotted on that Elise, they should have called off the play, but they overcommitted into a play that must have worked a ton of times in scrims. But nobody kind of punished them on that, and that's why they kept committing to it. But they weren't ready for, honestly, a really good flash from Mithy, and then the portal on level 2. It changed too many kind of factors, too many variables in that play, and suddenly Fnatic didn't have the adaptation in mind. And that single play honestly snowballed the entire game.
I mean, it's the same story as what happened last time with the land swap mistake. You can't afford to make these kind of plays and make these errors against a team like G2 Esports. They punish every single time. And, you know, again, the form that they're on, it's incredible to see them on this level because it just didn't look like that last week.
No. It's completely different G2 here. But again, they can make changes a lot more quicker than other teams because they have just raw talent.
You know the old saying, losers improve. It's definitely the case. G2 had a 1-1 on both their series the last week, and they came in ready to really turn that right around and reclaim the top spot. Remember, this is the defending champions of Europe so far, which is a title usually reserved for Fnatic.
I burst. Flash. Nope.
Okay, Rune Prisons instead. Oh, he stopped!
That's actually, that was not a failed combo from
Wait
the Alistar.
Wait a minute. He's going.
No, he's dead.
Yeah.
Let's just...
I want to see what went to.
Rip Perkovic, that was a mistake. That was not a failed combo by Yellowstar.
No.
Okay, everybody stop fighting. That was not a failed combo from Yellowstar because the correct play is to W and respect your opponent to be smart enough to flash, but Perk's flash was down. So Yellowstar wanted to W and then Q flash after Perk's, but he wasn't communicated that Perk's flash apparently was down in the earlier fight versus Gamsu. So if Perk's flash was down and was communicated, then it was a failed combo from Yellowstar.
Yeah.
Because nothing's happening, we have time to go into support, you know, finer mechanics. Because against, sadly, that's how you have to play Alistar at the highest level now. You have to W in and predict that they're so good that they're going to flash it, and then Q flash off to them.
I love it when you talk nerdy to me.
Do you?
In games like these, nothing better. All right.
Let's get dinner then, Pyra. Talk nerdy to you all night. As long as you pay for dinner.
We still got catering, right? Does that count?
You gonna get me Currywurst? Wars? You got me.
Hey man, it's a Berlin
bloody
fantasy.
Cold Currywurst? Wars. That's what you're getting me.
Oh god, spirit.
I'm giving you my darkest, deepest support tricks and tips, and I only get cold Currywurst Wars from catering.
Tell you
which
what,
is fantastic,
I'll heat it up
by the way.
For you.
Great. Fuck.
All right. So let's take a look at the catch on Perks and here.
I mean,
what you're talking
is,
about with the flash, right?
Just yeah. Like, so here, technically, Perks would flash, and then Yellowstar would Q flash after. Perks obviously does not have flash. So one begs the question. What is Perks doing there? And this is why myself, I don't like Perks on Ryze as much because he keeps getting caught in side lanes every game.
Yeah, I just smile and nod, by the way.
That's your role. We talked about
in a
game
this.
Pyro goes like, yeah, yeah, we did.
I remember this talk. All right, so it's 20 minutes in, but like the stranglehold just keeps getting deeper and deeper right now. Fnatic, I mean, obviously this game is a lost cause for them, but what is the slimmest thing that they can do? What can they actually find here to
exactly
try to get back
what
to
they
the
do right there. On cooldown, every Jhin ultimate, they fire on somebody holding a side lane. They slow him down and make sure he can't TP out. And then they close the gap with Moby Boots Alistar. Or maybe a Flash Cocoon. And that's what G2 need to learn to do better. Is because this game, they don't have double sidestone. So their 1-3-1 is significantly weaker vision-wise, which leads to people getting caught out. I like Zillion in the 1-3-1 a lot more because Perks has speed up. Perks with Zillion would have not died there.
Oh!
Now Reckless gets a spear.
Oh, and he is just evaporated. That is a whole lot of damage, and they stop him for a second. Tempered Fate, Trick, flashing away. Big Gnar stomps on the Goombas. It's Yellowstar and Febivin that are going down. And one misstep. Huge punishment. Yellowstar flashes away, but that's going to be in Hip Towers.
That was sexy. You know, the combo meter is 100% right there. Trick's going down. You know, Tempered Fate on three members plus his own jungler. Trick flashes out. Double Cosmic Binding into the alley-oop, dunk from expected to the side like wall, and then the follow-up from G2, that was just utter annihilation here on the side of Fnatic.
Yeah, 20-minute inhibitor after that big combo for them. They grab anything they want on the map. Fnatic overstepping their bounds just a little bit, and G2 slapping them back into place. That's going to be Infernal Dragon. That time is a little bit too low for G2 to try and push in to finish this game off just yet, but they're looking like that's the foregone conclusion.
Yeah. Love me some bar combos.
Finally get to play-by-play something, Kreffel.
Yep. Almost stole it from you going on a rant.
I'm glad you let up on the gas.
Get off my property. This is my world. Stuff's going on, I have to shout.
So you're like the guy who's yelling, kids get off my lawn, in this case the lawn is lane swap?
Well, yeah, that's my lane swap lawn.
Excellent. All right, let's
take
a look at
this again.
This is my
turn. Look, that's just, sometimes you gotta let a play breathe and just a double combo, spear, look at it. One layer, two layers, three layers of CC, another spear.
That Gnarhawk was dirty, man.
Yep, it's just...
They exhaust Perks, and he's like, I don't care.
This is mid-T player of the game. All those bindings landing, fantastic. Because I know we're going to get buzzed by our stats guys. Like, guys, do you have your Pog? Pog is player of the game.
Yes.
And for me, it's mid-T. Those bindings, man.
Honestly, like, his Bard play has been pretty fantastic across the board. But nobody on... Okay, I say nobody. There have been, like, as you said, a few small mistakes on the side of G2. But in this entire series, in all honesty, we haven't seen a lot of individual mistakes outside of maybe Trick getting caught or Perks getting...
Yeah.
Except for Expect getting caught a little bit last game.
Both.
This game?
Both Expect and Perks.
And Perks now, yeah. Like, and it's one time. Okay, Mithy does face tank.
No, that's a calculated risk because he knows he has backup.
Oh! Okay.
Spirit hops over the arrow.
That's fine, though. Like, it's a low enough cooldown for them to just keep on pushing in. You've got Expect. They have the 4-1. They keep on roving through the jungle. I mean, Fnatic are... They're not blind. They've got a few wards down, but, I mean, look at what G2 have got here. There's just no ground they can really run to.
Yeah, they're just isolating the Baron right now. Spirit, knowing that those spiders have many more knees than just a functional human being, so he definitely needs to dodge that arrow. And he hops over, and now is just waiting for the face check.
Oh, and they get it. There's a big combo, but in comes Trick to try and turn the damage around. They just don't have any. Teleport here. Desperation time for Fnatic. In comes Gamsu, but Perks has already taken out Yellowstar. Flag and drag, and into the chains they go. And that's not going to be nearly enough to take out anybody except for Perks. Last tick of the Chaos Storm. Febivin, nearly untouched, but Expect starts to instantly turn that around and chase down not one, not two, but three members of Fnatic. Expect just going wild. And now Spirit tanking the spear, Trick hops on him, and that arrow isn't even needed. Big fight for G2, big cleanup.
Expect goes mental, 1v3 on the backline here with this Gnar. I really like the Jarvan Victor combo if it works. It kind of goes from a Chaos Storm to a Chaos Pit. Everybody's stuck into these walls, taking the inevitable storm damage that ticks every 2 seconds. And it worked, but there simply wasn't enough damage. We saw the new Alistar 2 post nerf. Yeah, you push your ultimate, you're no longer invisible. Yellowstar dropped like a hot knife to Butter, and then the cleanup came from Expect.
Yeah, I definitely liked the Chaos Dunk, but it just wasn't enough damage, like you said. They've been too far behind. And you can see, they were 1v2 for a minute,
Mithy
and that's
exhaust.
About it.
Yeah, Exhaust comes out. Yellowstar here, just... That's
your tankiest member, by the way.
And then here, Chaos Dunk, as you said, really beautiful, but if this happens on an even game, this is like a game-winning play. But it's not enough, because Expect's like, guys, I'm a fed top laner, despite early lane stop shenanigans.
Yep.
And he goes for the flash finish here as he goes into Mega Gnar. Beautiful.
Yeah, scoops him right into the wall. And then Spirit's pretty much left hanging. And yeah, it's all cleanup crew for G2 here. They definitely know how to take a game to its logical conclusion. So they isolate out the Baron. Easy peasy. They don't even need to take it right now because they keep on chasing. It's only 24 and a half minutes in, remember. This is a 9,000 gold lead. It's just been snowballing out of control since that early game.
They know the only way they can throw is through Baron. So they need the perfect setup. They have like 10,000 gold that they can spend securing the Baron. Which they can do inefficiently, and then they still get it, they'll still win the game because of the position of the map.
You know, what's really important for G2, though, and obviously these two games, it's probably hard to demonstrate some of these weaknesses, but we always have been criticizing them for being just a smidgen over-aggressive sometimes. Mm-hmm. Somebody flashing, trying to get the quick cleanup kill. They've controlled their aggression so well these two games. And it's been so calculated. This is the goal. This was what they were striving for. We're seeing it here. This is a team that has gone Super Saiyan.
Yeah. And Trix, which Super Saiyan, though? Early in the series when they're playing weak opponents, or later on?
I think it's like somewhere between 1 and 2, so the hair just keeps growing right now.
Yeah, right.
He's caught, but he's got a magical journey. It's going to stop the Baron, but look, they didn't even need to finish it. Febivin. He's caught in the Tempered Fate, they chain it in, the Chaos Storm comes, but that's not anything that they needed. Expect, he's still 1v3, they turn to Reckless, pounce on him, a double kill over to Trick, and it's Yellowstar's turn to fall, a triple kill for the Kitty Cat, and that's gonna be base.
In terms of like blonde hair length, I was gonna ask you, is it Reckless level of Super Saiyan, but this looks like a Nuke Duck level of Super Saiyan from G2 Esports here, complete domination. I got one tweet saying, Greppo, it was a 14-minute game, this wasn't domination in game one. Well, guess what? This one is G2 just towering at shoulders above Fnatic based all on that first play and then super clean map play gets them two inhibitors and full access to the Baron.
12,000 gold, 8 towers to 3. They've taken every objective in the game, given so few away. Fnatic have nowhere to run. G2, it's a matter of time before they come knocking.
Yeah, and while this is such a sweep, it's very easy to identify the key moments in both these games. So the replay analysis for Fnatic will honestly be rather swift. There's three phases in game one, and then there's one phase in game two, and that's it done. So at least they know where to look for their faults. For G2, they also know where to refine their strategy. They really need to be more careful here being picked off. And also, they need to stop relying on individually outplaying opponents in some of these skirmishes too. Here we saw the engage on Mithy, but he can still get into a portal despite being denied once. And Fevin just the very end. And then, yeah, the chain CC comes out.
Meanwhile, Expect.
Yep, Expect his support.
I mean, he demands so much pressure at this point. Like, this Gnar play is ridiculous. Yes, yeah. They're ahead, but I mean, come on, he keeps getting the multi-bops.
Now, obviously, G2 Esports is looking at potentially going to Worlds, obviously, given the amount of circuit points that they've gathered, etc. And they need to stop relying on just individually outplaying opponents too and look more for these, like, really efficient macro plays. Because if you get to the highest level, honestly, when you play the likes of SKT, etc., they're going to match you in individual skill, and then, obviously, strategy is required.
Yep. Peel off the Baron. That's step one, though, is getting that LCS title once again. Sven and Mithy joining this team, trying to get their first LCS title, but they can beat the old Kings of Europe and keep the dominance going. It looks like that is going to be the case, and it has never looked so easy. Taking out Yellowstar, chasing Spirit. He might have eight legs, but he's not running fast enough.
Yeah. But this is... It's just an unfair battle at this point for Fnatic. They're like fighting with the kid sword.
Oh.
You ever played the Legend of Zelda games? Like the first free little sword that you get? That's what Fnatic's wielding right now. And G2 has got the upgraded Master Sword.
Yeah.
It's not really fair. 12,000 gold lead at 28 minutes is something.
They've been collecting rupees while they go too.
Yeah. They have a sixth member worth in gold right now.
Jeez.
G2 Esports.
Yeah, they're not lacking for money. And this Baron will start to put the final nail in the coffin. 28 minutes and down it goes since nobody there to contest. Super minions in two lanes here for Fnatic to desperately deal with as they start knocking down the towers. Keep on flowing, and G2, they can take their time and scenically roll through the Summoner's Rift before finishing this victory.
Yeah, they can look at some of the wonders that we've put into this game. They can pass by the frog that our observers so frantically obsessed about.
And the owls.
And the owls, honestly.
It's a Harry Potter menagerie in here.
Honestly, a bit too much at times. It's a little scary how much Kevin loves his owl. Hey.
Yeah.
Let's watch this again.
Yeah.
Before we get into owl business.
I was going to talk about observers being trolls. This is more important.
Yeah. Zoning ultimate for Mithy. That's what we call them.
Yeah.
As you missed. No. I was simply moving the enemy forward into the fight with the ultimate. Expect. Turns out that Gnar can get pretty tanky. And yeah, chase happens. And then look at Victor. He's there. Eventually, I don't think he will be there anymore. Do they actually kill him this fight? Yeah, portal comes over. Fevin drastically trying to wave
clear. Surprise!
Exhaust to flash on perks. Guess what? Fevin drops too. It's too easy right now.
Yeah. I mean, this is the thing is, like, neither team really would know what happens in the scrim because this is that point where you open mid.
This is where you say, like, GG well played, go next.
Yeah. So it's 30 minutes. I mean, this is just a slow march in. Fnatic, they know they've lost so much ground. We might see one blast before the end.
Yeah.
Gamsu EQs. He's going to get knocked by the arrow, though. And there's a big Gnar. He's going to go golden for a second. And the Fnatic members start to drop. Yellowstar going first. Sven takes him out. Gamsu goes for the dunk. The Chaos Storm, not enough damage. And they want to pad those stats. But that's Inhibitor. And G2 Esports, 2-0, Clinic on Fnatic.
Yeah, that phase where those three Inhibitors were down at the very end. Fnatic, you know, vying for the throne. But if that was a wedding, the Reigns of Castamere would start playing right there. Sadly, swift end to Fnatic's chances in this series. Honestly, beautiful 2-0 here from G2. At least Spirit can still smile. That's what I love about that guy. He's always smiling. Fnatic taking it, honestly, reasonably well.
You have to take a loss like that in stride, even if there's not a whole lot you can do. Fnatic, definitely the kings of coming back and looking stronger.
I hope no fans watch this and is like, why are they smiling? They're not taking it serious. You know, at one point, you know you've got outclassed and you got to go back to the drawing board. As a player that always used to get angry after losses, like, I would always rage at myself after loss, and I would be so upset that my teammates would never be equally upset, you know, because how can they not care enough? It is the wrong mentality. I think it's great to see that Fnatic here, honestly, take it with a smile. They know where they messed up. They can easily identify these mistakes, and they know exactly what they need to fix for next week. Hopefully, they start fixing it.
And it's better now than playoffs. I mean, Fnatic as a team, they know that this kind of loss, you can learn quite a bit from about yourself, about your opponents. Losers improve. But for now...
You have been playing a lot of solo queues.
Just enough.
And that's quite sadly, that's one of the only phrases that you can actually put on broadcast.
Yeah.
That you hear all the time.
Yeah, you do hear a lot of things that you're not allowed to say on broadcast.
Don't think about the other phrases.
I'm not going to go into the other ones. Don't jinx me on this. But yeah, Fnatic, they can definitely take a lot away from that. But for G2, they can go back and be very happy with the fact that they systematically demolished their biggest competition in Europe today.
Yeah, and now this is where G2 is kind of, why did we lose points to these teams? Why did we lose these series last few weeks?
Yeah.
But honestly, at the at
back
the,
on top.
At the end of, honestly, the first half of the split, remember we were approaching...
We're officially halfway.
Yeah, we're officially halfway right now. And every team has played every team once. G2 is at the top, and that's what they wanted.
That's kind of what we expected. I mean, there were a few stumbling blocks, but we started to see these teams that have really got their stuff together, climbing back into it. Fnatic, you know, really challenging for that second spot. Clearly couldn't really match up to what G2 were doing today. Oh. But this is G2 at, I don't know if it's their cap, but it's clearly at something that is nothing anyone else in your
computer. Gotta hold your horses, your fire. Yeah. Both these games were decided by very early, like, lane swap kind of shifts out of the mold. Both aggressively by G2 punishing Gans in the first game, and then Fnatic going for a kind of, whoa, what is this play in the second game that backfired. So,
yeah. All right.
No sweeping statements.
But we're gonna have a while before we get to see them play again. But that was, yeah, I mean, that was very strong performance from G2. Now, for more on that series win, we're gonna go and set.